So guys, in today's video, I'm going to be speaking about something which doesn't get spoken about too often about cars, and that aspect is the engine mount. So it's actually funny how it's a wear and tear item that supports the entire weight of the engine, yet not a lot of people are even aware about this. And a possible reason for this fact is that typical owners might end up changing their cars in 5 to 6 years, thus never even having to worry about the engine mounting. So now most modern cars have differently designed engine mounts depending on the engine weight, orientation of the engine, and the power rating. And these are the factors which determine the cost and materials of the mount. This video is not really a tutorial about replacing the mounts, but I'll still be sharing my experiences and feedback about the same. I'll leave links to my friend's channel, Your DIY Needs, and he's made detailed videos about how to change these mounts on Polos and Ventos. Now, there are a lot of documented symptoms to help you identify a bad engine mounting, but I'm only going to be sharing my experiences. So I would feel a thud and a wholesome shake when the engine was started in the morning, and all of this was accompanied by vibrations which were felt on the steering wheel and even some body trims like the dashboard or the door panels when the engine was idling. Now, most people I've met just ended up saying that the old 1.9 TDI engine that I have is really unrefined and that is the cause of heavy vibrations, but this is actually far from true. The other things that I noticed, the car was pulling to one side on heavy acceleration. Even when the car tire alignment was perfect and the road was perfectly flat, my car with incredible Yokohama Bluer tires would hesitate and then pull to one side and then start gaining that speed. And whenever I put my foot down, there would always be that noticeable lag after which the car would leap forward. And then there were also a couple of occasions when I felt I was hearing clunking noises on heavy acceleration. So the engine mounts are usually pieces of rubber which are sandwiched in a metal housing. Some engine mounts may also have a hydraulic element to it for better dampening the engine vibrations. So the job of an engine mount is to no doubt secure the engine onto the car's chassis, but it's also designed to allow controlled movement to transmit power to the roads. So from experience with a few old cars we've had, I can safely say that most engine mounts are designed to not catastrophically fail, but the function of the mounts is not just to safely support the engine, but to also allow the car to be smoothly driven with minimal vibration. Now, as a car ages, after driving on a variety of driving conditions like good roads and even bad roads, and even due to the impact of atmospheric constituents, these rubber pieces start weakening and develop micro cracks. And this is usually a slow process, but the breakdown can be dramatically accelerated if you get a remap done, for instance. So most cars might have a similar set of 5 mounts, an engine side hydraulic mount, a gearbox mount, a dog bone or pendulum mount, because it's literally shaped like a dog bone, and there's also a pair of subframe mounts which are kind of unique as they're rubber inserts circumscribed by a polymeric housing. So the metallic body of the mounts have a manufacturing date stamped on them, which can be seen as a circle with the year marked inside. So rubber as an engineering commodity doesn't like to sit around too much, as it can lose its elasticity and cohesivity depending on how it's packed and stored. So it's actually a really good practice to inspect the packing date of the mount while buying them from a parts store, and if the date is older than 2 to 3 years, it's wise to request for a new part with a newer date. So my car was running stock for about 80,000 kilometers with a nominal amount of vibration and was rated to make 105 bhp. With a stage 2 remap with EGR deleted, the engine vibrations just shot through the roof, and this was perhaps why the DSG transmission side mount was completely short. So the hydraulic engine mount still could have managed a little longer. So here's a side-by-side look of the old and the new engine mount, and straight away you can see that the rubber elements on the old mounting have broken down from multiple places, and because of that I can fairly easily move the mount without too much of a resistance. The new mount is firm, resilient and crack-free, just the way it should be. So engine mounts are usually replaced with the engine supported by either a crane or a floor jack. And since this task seemed a little tough for me to tackle alone, I visited my friend's garage to get help. With the engine safely supported, we take the old engine mounts off and throw in the new engine mounts, which need to be perfectly aligned onto the mounting points. So Volkswagen recommends replacing the engine mounting bolts, but the set of mounting bolts is not freely available in the market. So unlike the engine and transmission mounts, the subframe mounts cannot directly be replaced. They have to be pressed into the subframe using a hydraulic press. And this is what the bush pressing of a lower control arm bush looks like. The rubber of my old subframe mounting also had plenty of cracks and free play. So like most car parts, engine mounts are also made by aftermarket companies and the cost depends on the quality of the rubber and the metal castings. I chose ZF Lemforder mounts because they are an OE supplier to Volkswagen and many other European companies. So if you pick lower quality mountings, then there's a good chance you'll just have to replace them sooner than the original ones lasted. So coming to how much difference the new mounts made, there was a dramatic difference. The car has gotten quieter, the engine no longer shakes when I start the car, the car seems to be delivering a lot more power on the roads, and my 11-year-old car suddenly feels a lot younger. So if you have a vibration problem on your high mileage car, then do consider replacing your engine mounts.